We are here with Bob, the very generous and cool owner of this amazing 59 Studebaker wagon. And we're gonna hear, it's very hot out here, folks, so we're gonna hear a few details from him before we just melt right here in our places. Yeah. Bob, thank you.
So I have to start with how I got this car, because it's an interesting story. I found it in a raffle in Oklahoma City for a kid with cancer. And I saw the car, I fell in love with it immediately, had to have it, entered the raffle, lost. The winner of the raffle had a choice between a 1978 Corvette and this, and he took the Corvette. So now I'm like, I gotta find this car. My neighbor moved to Oklahoma City and he was a car salesman. So I called him up, I said, Russ, I got a car I need you to find, and I sent him a picture. And he goes, Bob, you're not gonna believe this, but that's my boss's car, it sits in our showroom.
Oh my gosh.
I said, that's BJ's car? He goes, yeah. And I go, well, I want it. And he goes, he'll never sell it to you. And I said, well, we'll see about that. So 4.5 years later, I finally figured out how to get the car from BJ. And he was a high-end car dealer. I had a triple black 2002 SL500 AMG. Took a picture of it, sent it to him, and the deal was done. And so it's a beautiful car. It's been freshened up. It's got some very unique features that I'd like to share. One, if you're a Studebaker guy, you know it right away, and that's the grill. The grill is not the grill out of the car. The grill is out of the Champ pickup. But it fits in the same hole, and to me, it was one of Studebaker's real faux pas, because the Champ grill is beautiful,
sure,
and the Lark grill is a piece of wire.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
The motor is a LP1 out of a 92 Corvette, paired with a 700 R4, pushing about 400 horse, built out of Mina Speed Shop in Arkansas. Griffin radiator. The other interesting detail and customization on it is this stainless steel would stop right about here out of the factory. And I didn't like it because it didn't separate the two-tone properly. So I found some stainless, and we welded it in and grafted it on and made it full length.
Wow, beautiful touch. I'd say that was the right call.
The other one that, again, unless you're really a diehard Studebaker guy, you would never notice it. If you looked at a stock Studebaker Lark, this wheel well opening would come to about here. So the fender was cut, pulled in, and then filled.
Wow.
To close up the wheel well a little bit.
You got all the details,
Other
and they
than
paid
that,
off.
She's pretty stock. The front end is a Mustang II with Alden coilovers, and because of the weight of it, I had to go to Eibach Springs on the Alden coilovers.
Definitely heard of those.
The rest of the car is just a stock Studebaker. A couple little touches of billet in the interior. The rack I made, these are some old mounts that you used to be able to buy. You can't buy them anymore, so if you find them, grab them. And then this is actually a handle for a stairway.
Oh, man.
That I shaped and put on it.
Got some genius touches here, Bob, for sure. And tell us a little bit, because I got to give a little shout out to a buddy of mine, Richard, loves seafoam green. Is that a stock color arrangement with the interior?
Not.
Okay.
So they never came in seafoam. They never came two-tone.
Okay.
So the two-tone and the seafoam is, this one was kind of a powder blue. Again, another mistake that Studebaker made. They should have all been two-tone.
Gotcha.
Because it makes the car look 1,000 times better. And with the trim, it's a natural setup for it.
I think it looks amazing, beautiful, gorgeous.
And then I have to do a little shout out to my buddy. He's a Hall of Fame pinstriper, Johnny Martinez. And these are some of Johnny's art that I've collected over the years and carry with me.
Oh, wow.
Those are actually traffic signal lenses that he stripes.
Wow, look at that. And you're right, he does do incredible work. Johnny Martinez, right?
Yes.
So you heard it right there, folks.
Wicked Lines.
Wicked Lines. Maybe we'll tag him on Insta if he's out there. Yeah, either way is going to get a mention for sure. And the seafoam chair, folks. We got it all.
Yeah, that's courtesy of the wife. She had to match it.
Nice.
So it's a car I love. I'll never get rid of it. I'll have it forever. And I put one more touch on it because I'm a Marine.
Thank you for your service.
And I have to do a shout out to all my Marines. So on the hood here, which depending on the angle is very difficult to see, my painter ghosted in.
Oh yeah.
A Marine Corps emblem.
Semper Fi.
And it's a pearl, and depending on the angle, it goes from invisible to bright gold.
Wow. Bob, sorry to cut you off there a moment ago. Looks amazing. And again, I want to just say for everybody out there, thank you for your service.
Hey, no worries. I had a lot of fun.
There you go.
My Marine days were good days. So that's the car. It's and the amazing thing is I can drive it anywhere, anytime. She doesn't let me down.
Fantastic. Well, Bob, I mean, you've been beyond generous, besides your service again, and just showing us the car and talking about the origin story and everything you've done to it. On behalf of myself and anyone who may watch, thank you so much.
Thank you.
And it was a pleasure meeting you.
Pleasure meeting you.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.